morning. Yesterday we have learned the poem Legend of Northland. And now further, we have come to know about the values or the good virtues of a human being, that what a human being is expected to be. God always demands respect for other human beings. Moreover, helpfulness, kind and generosity for others. And those persons who don't have these kind of qualities, they are definitely be punished sooner or later. So this is what we have studied in this poem. So in this Legend of Northland, we have also come to know that a woman was greedy enough, she was not ready to part with her piece of cake. As she did not want to give the cake she had baked to Saint Peter. Why she is not ready? Because she thought that the cakes she has made, they are quite large to be given to somebody else, but they are too small to eat herself. So she was not ready to give her cake to anybody, okay? Especially when Saint Peter, he has come to her house. She was not at all ready. And naturally, this kind of behavior, because Saint Peter, who was tired of preaching throughout the day, he was moving from one place to another, and it is really very difficult for him to to cope up with this kind of situation. He wanted something to eat, but the woman, Ash, was not ready to give him anything. So this evoked his anger. So ultimately what happened? From here, we are going to start. Students are still angry. Yes. And he said, "You are too selfish to dwell in human form." So, what he said, Saint Peter in anger said to the woman that you are too selfish, that you are not at all, you can say, you are not at all deserving to be a human being. And you never deserve to be a human being. You do not deserve to be a human form. You should not be a human. To have both food and shelter, and fire to keep you warm, and you are enjoying the facilities which are given to human beings, as they can store their food, they can take shelter, they can protect themselves from any kind of weather, like you are protecting yourself from this cold weather. And moreover, you can keep yourself warm in cold weather. But the birds and animals who also are suffering from this kind of weather, and ultimately they have to go from one place to another in order to protect themselves. They have to find their food, and moreover, in order to protect themselves from this kind of weather, they have to put strong and stern efforts. But as you are not having human qualities, are not deserved, you are not deserving to be a human form, and you are not deserving to live in a human form. Now, you shall build as the birds do. As the birds do, build as the birds do. This is an example of simile. Now you shall build as the birds do. Now what you will do? Now you will live a life of birds. Like birds, they have to move from one place to another in order to build their nest also. And they pick up one small twig or straw in order to build up their homes. In the same manner, you also have to do. And shall get your scanty food. Birds don't have plenty of food. They move from one place to another in order to gather their food, which was scanty, which is less in amount, by boring and boring and boring all day in the hard dry wood. And how they are preparing their food? They are getting their food by boring and boring. By boring means by piercing with their beak into the strong bark of the tree. So ultimately, what is there? So you shall, what you will do, that you will get your food by boring and boring into the dry wood. Only then you will be able to get your food and shelter. Otherwise, you will not get your food and shelter. So the poet is saying that the human beings, they should be thankful to God as they have got various kind of facilities and moreover bounties of nature. They are the God's finest creation. They are getting whatever they want. They are getting whatever is being desired by them. They are getting everything in plenty, food, shelter, and everything. But this doesn't mean that they should be thankless. No, they should be thankful towards God, and they should have a generous attitude towards other fellow beings. Otherwise, if they are not doing so, they never deserve to be human beings. So the poet, through this poem, is delivering us the lesson that what kind of qualities must be imbibed by human beings in their character and in their personalities. Then up she went through the chimney, never speaking a word. And out of the top flew a woodpecker, for she was changed to a bird. Yes, then up she went. Then with these words, because Saint Peter is not a normal human being, he is endowed with some magical powers also. He has changed the women with his words into woodpecker. So what happened? So because of that, what happened? As he spoke these words, this woman, she went through the chimney. There was a chimney where the furnace was there, and it is connected to that of chimney, which is acting as an outlet of smoke or outlet for smoke. From that chimney, she went up and came out of that chimney in the form of a woodpecker. Okay, she has turned into a woodpecker. She was not at all speaking a word. She was not at all speaking a word, for she was changed to a bird. Because she was changed to a bird, it means that Saint Peter has changed the woman into a woodpecker. Okay, so Saint Peter has changed the woman into a woodpecker. She had a scarlet cap on her head, and that was left the same. Scarlet is a deep red color. So what is there? She had a scarlet cap on her head. On her head, what was there? A scarlet cap. Deep red blue colored cap, it was there. And that remained so, and it was not at all changed. But all the rest of her clothes were burned. But all her clothes, what happened to all her clothes? All her clothes, they were burned. They were burned in the chimney and in the fire, and black as coal as in the flame. And they all have turned as black as coal. It signifies that how woodpecker got its black body. Okay, so this woman with its scarlet cap, having, you can say, a pointed tip at the head, it remained in the same manner. But what happened? But the other clothes of the woman, they were burnt into the chimney, and they have turned out to be as black as coal. And every country schoolboy has seen in the wood where she lives in the trees till this very day, boring and boring for food. Now every country schoolboy means that every school going boy, now whenever they are passing through woods, through thickets of trees, through forests, they must have seen the bird flying in the sky and boring into the trees to find its food. So who's this? So they have come to know it is nobody else, but this is the same woman who has been changed into a woodpecker by the saints. And ultimately, what happened that she has been changed into a woodpecker, and every schoolboy, he has come to know about this story. And this woman, she's now not at all enjoying the facilities of nature. She's not at all getting all the things which are given by God to human beings as a gift. But now what she's doing, she's boring and boring for her food in the bark of the trees, and moreover making shelter for living also. So what it means? It means that this poem, it is delivering us the message that we as human beings, if we turn a deaf ear towards the feelings of others, if we turn a deaf ear to the feelings of others, ultimately it is only we who have to suffer. Because such people, they are never welcomed and they are never appreciated in the house of God also, right? So as we have studied the chapter Happy Prince also, we have studied the chapter Happy Prince, okay? So in the chapter also, what we have got to know? We have got to know there also that when the God has told the angel to bring the two most beautiful things from earth, what he has brought? He has brought the leaden heart of the prince, and moreover he has also brought the dead body of the swallow, right? So what this shows also, again, good people, good souls, or you can say kind souls, they are always welcomed by God. They always find a place in the house of God, and they are always appreciated by everyone. And those persons who never pay attention towards others, who don't have the feeling of empathy. What is empathy means? E-M-P-A-T-H-Y. Empathy means it's the feeling of understanding, or it's a understanding to have the feeling to understand the values as well as the feelings of others, or to understand feelings of others is called as empathy. So what it means? It means that one should be empathetic in nature. One should understand the feelings of others. One should always be kind and generous towards others. If we have these kind of qualities, only then we will be appreciated by God also. Otherwise, we have to suffer. We have to face the punishment for not paying our attention towards others in one or the other form. And that, this is what we have learned from this point. So this poem is also delivering us the message that good persons and kind persons, kind souls, generous souls, they are always welcomed by God. And those who are cruel enough, who are not good at heart, who are not soft at heart, they also have to face many problems in their lives. And moreover, on that day, I have also told you that this poem is a ballad. Why this poem is a ballad? Again, I am repeating, this poem is a ballad because this poem is narrating a story. Okay, in short stanzas. This poem, it contains a story in short stanzas. And moreover, this is part of the popular folk culture of Northland. And every child of that area, of that region, he must have come to know about the story of this woman. And ultimately, there is a moral given at the end of this story, at the end of this poem, that goodness is a great virtue of human beings, and one should not be devoid of this virtue, as this kind of virtue will always bring kindness and moreover respect to human beings. Right? So what is a ballad? I once again repeat, a ballad is a song narrating a story in short stanzas, and they are part of folk culture or popular culture and are passed on orally from one generation to the next. This is exactly given in your books. So any doubt in this poem, if you have, you can ask me. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. That's fine. Okay. Right? So coming up to the question answers given here, let us do. Which country or countries do you think the Northland refers to? Just raise up your hands now. Raise up your hands. Yes, Eva.
Countries or which are refers to Northland are those which have long days and short nights.
Which have long days and short nights. There is prevalence of extreme cold weather. It means that the people who are living there, they are suffering from extreme cold weather. Yes, Vanshika, you can also speak. Yes, ma'am. Yes. Anshika, you want to speak?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, speak out. So, Lavlina, you can speak.
Yes, ma'am. The countries the Northland refers to are those where the winter, which experience harsh winters and have long nights than days.
Okay, have long nights than days, and moreover, extreme cold weather prevails there. What did Saint Peter ask the old lady for, and what was the lady's reaction? What did Saint Peter ask the old lady for?
He asked for cake, a single piece.
Panika will explain.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Saint Peter asked the old lady to bake a single piece of cake and to satisfy his hunger. And the lady tried to bake a small cake for the saint.
Okay. So, Saint Peter, as he was tired of preaching throughout the day, and what he wanted, so in order to satiate his hunger, he wanted to eat something. Finally, where he came across a small cottage where a lady was baking the cakes. So Saint Peter asked the lady for a piece of cake, so that he can fill his appetite. And how did he punish her? Sorry, what was the lady's reaction? The second part of the question is, what was the lady's reaction? The lady was not at all willing to give even a small piece of cake also. First of all, she baked the cake. She thought that it is too big to be given to Saint Peter. She took a very small piece of dough and baked it as thin as wafer. Still, she thought that it is too big to be given to somebody else. And looking at this inhuman behavior, this led to evoke the anger of Saint Peter, and ultimately he cursed the lady. Next question is, how did he punish her? How did he punish her? Yes, Ramni.
May I?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
He punished the lady by changing her into a woodpecker that would have to build a nest to live in and gather scanty food all day long by boring in the hard dry wood.
Yes. How did he punish her? He punished the lady as the lady was not ready to part with her piece of cake. So he caused the lady to be changed into a woodpecker. And as soon as he spoke these words, the lady came out of the chimney. All her clothes burnt up as black as coal, with the but her scarlet cap in the same form remained at her edge. So she was changed into a woodpecker who will bore and bore into where? Into the barks of the trees to gather food. How does the woodpecker get her food, Dia?
The old lady was turned into a woodpecker by Saint Peter, for she had been very ungenerous. The woodpecker gets her food by drilling very small holes in the tree or boring through the tree barks of the tree to feed on insects, sap and other forms of food.
Yes. So how does the woodpecker get her food? As the woodpecker has to move from one place to another to procure its food. Similarly, the lady who was changed into woodpecker, she was also getting her food in the same manner by boring and boring into the barks of the trees and moving from one place to another also, right? Next question is, do you think that the old lady would have been so ungenerous if she had known who Saint Peter really was? What would she have done then? She would have done that if she knew that who Saint Peter was. Yes, Panika?
No, the lady would not have been so ungenerous. She had known who Saint Peter really was. And instead, she would be welcomed him in her house happily and given him several large cakes to please him and to get his blessings.
So finally, that she would not have been so ungenerous. She would have welcome Saint Peter, and if she knew the magical powers of Saint Peter too, she must have welcomed Saint Peter to her small cottage and would have served her with a number of cakes, as she knew that one reluctant act on her part would change her into woodpecker. So ultimately, she would not have behaved in this manner. She would have been more generous as well as kind towards Saint Peter. But ultimately, by behaving in this ungenerous manner, the reality of the lady, it has been brought into light. And moreover, through this reality of the lady, the poet is able to bring out the lesson of life to be generous and kind towards others. Right? So this is what we have learned from this poem. Is this story a true story, and which part of the poem do you feel is the most important? Do you think,
ma'am? Can I?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, can I?
It is a true story. I think the para 5 and 6 are the most important in this poem, because in those paragraphs, Saint Peter came to the door of a cottage after traveling around the world, where a little woman was making cakes and baking them on a hearth. And Saint Peter was dying from hunger and needed some help, but the lady didn't offered him some cakes to satisfy his hunger.
Okay, is this a true story?
Excuse me, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. It is a legend.
It's a legend.
Story. The poet who wants to deliver us a So, according to you, paragraph 5 and 6. But I feel that the paragraphs where the Saint Peter has given her a lesson, okay, that she was trained that she should move by boring and boring, find her food by boring and boring into the dry wood, that are most important. This is where the lady, she is getting her lesson of life. Okay. Next, afterwards, what is a legend and why is this poem called a legend? Why? What is a legend? What is a legend?
Legend is an popular story.
Yes,
please.
A legend is a story that has that from the past that carries an important message. It is generally not true and is a part of folk culture, which has been passed orally from one generation to next.
Yes, it's a part
The poet,
right, which is passed on from one generation to another. So why is this poem called a legend? This poem is of course called a legend. Why it is called as legend? Because this story in which a woman was changed into a woodpecker, it has traveled from one person, from one generation to another. And moreover, every school going boy who has seen a woodpecker flying in the woods, they must have been considering it as the same woodpecker who was changed by Saint Peter, or who was changed by Saint Peter from a lady. So ultimately, what is this? This is a legend which was traveling from generations to come and delivering them the lesson to be generous, kind, and empathetic towards others. This is the reason why this poem is called a legend. Okay? Now you have to write down this story, a legend of Northland, in about 10 seconds. This is your own creativity. But now, if you have to write it, let me listen. Now, Dia will speak out this story, the story of legend of Northland in her own words.
The poem, A Legend of Northland, narrates the legend of an old lady who angered the Saint Peter because of her greed. It gives us a life lesson that we should be generous and grateful for what we have. It starts giving us information about the Northland, telling us that it is a place where days are few, hours of the days are few, and nights are long. Saint Peter was, after a long day of preaching, felt very hungry and tired. He came across an old woman who was baking cakes. He asked her from her store of cakes to give him a single one, but she was reluctant to give one, for she was very greedy and could not give away a piece of cake for free. She made a very little cake, but as it came out of the oven, it seemed fairly large. Therefore, she needed another one, but for her, it also seemed large. She then said that her cakes are that seem too small when she eats them are yet too big to give away. This angered Saint Peter, for he was very hungry and after a long day of preaching. And the woman was enough to provoke a saint. Therefore, he said that she was far too selfish to dwell in human form and to have a food and shelter and to live in such a luxurious life. Therefore, he turned him into a woodpecker, so that she had to work hard all day, boring through bark of tree to get food and shelter. After she had been turned into a woodpecker, she flew away without saying a word. She still had a scarlet cap on her head, and the rest of her clothes were burned, which were as black as a coal. This signifies the color of the woodpecker, which usually has a black body but a red head. And it is believed that every schoolboy who passes through is seen, whenever sees a woodpecker, considers the old lady. It gives us a message that we should never turn a deaf ear towards the feelings of others, and should always be generous and give away things whenever one needs.
Very good, Dia. that's all about the discussion. Tomorrow we will discuss extra questions of this point, right? Okay, so let me take your attendance.